anything over $200,000, up to $100,000.
$200,000?
I'm sorry, anything over $2,000, up to $100,000, requires competitive bidding, and the city will only make those purchases if there's competitive bidding.
I understand what you're saying, but the charter talks about.
Is there any further, is there any further open business?
Even if you put in a proposal, or you put in a quote, you're gonna end up with a contract with the city. That's what it is, those are contracts.
He can provide the information that he has before you, but your time has expired, thank you.
Chairman.
Councilman Brady.
I just wanted to speak to this for a minute, and I commend you, Ms. Carroll, for bringing this up, and being concerned about our city that you live in, and I appreciate it. When I was on council before, for 8 years, and then I came back now, I learned about this purchasing policy. I agree with you, a policy cannot supersede our charter, absolutely not. I do have questions about our purchase policy. So that's something I'm looking into too. I didn't have a chance to look at your information, and I'm happy to hear some of the comments from Chairman and our attorney. And I am looking into it as well, that's what we used to do before and what we're doing now. So your hard work isn't for nothing. We're all up here listening, and we're talking about it amongst ourselves, so I thank you for that. And it's real, it's not.
It's real.
It's real.
It's real.
So this new administration, they were, some of them were here before too, so they're trying to fix things that they've seen that are problematic, you know, every time we come here, we're doing something else that corrects things. So this is good conversation, and I appreciate it a lot, and I'm sure, I can't speak for anybody else, but we appreciate it, and we're looking at it, and we're gonna bring some more information up, and I'm interested to seeing it. And I did talk to Mr. Quinter about this before, and I'm researching as well. Did you read through the purchase policy? It's kind of giant, right?
Yeah, I read through the whole thing.
Yeah, yeah, so this, it'll, all your concerns will be addressed, and they'll be addressed up here, every single one that you have, and you live here, and this is good. This is a good conversation.
Thank you very much, to the chair, to Ms.
No, no, ma'am, ma'am.
Ma'am Grant, can I?
No, I have a comment to the council, right? Be prepared for the next study session. Let's go through this, the policy and the process, because I certainly don't want items real, when you say it's real, versus perceived. And I don't want anybody to make an assertion unless you have documentation that anything is being done illegally. And to continue to pull at that thread without having any data to back it up, to say that we are or are not doing something, because I've heard it from this council many times, that our corporation counsel provides legal advice. We know that Mrs. Carroll has engaged counsel on her own. And I've been, you know, contacted by a lawyer. So at this point in time, and I afforded 4 or 5 minutes beyond the 3 minutes, probably more time than that, which I did with the other people that came up and spoke. But at this point in time, we want to go through the item. I would suggest to the council that we do it with corporation counsel, with the administration, and make certain that we're all on the same page on how the processes, whether or not how they've been done, but more importantly, how they are being done going forward. We are in the process of being audited, which is our normal annual process, where Plant Moran comes in and looks at our financial controls. They are who we hire to go through and make certain that we are doing things in a legal as well as a, you know, GASB and the various things. So I would suggest for the next council meeting, next study session, let's ask corporation counsel, as we did before, and there may have been a confusion on what exactly he wanted to follow up on, but from or additional information. But let's take the time, not necessarily in the council meeting, and we can certainly give a report out at that point in time. But there's been a number of questions concerning concerns, issues raised, and...
Chairman.
Council.
So what I'm talking about being real is the fact that our charter, I believe, says that, and the purchasing policy says something different. That is real. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I saw. As soon as I got here, I saw it. So, I mentioned it, we talked about it, up here. So I'm not threatening anybody or accusing anybody of anything. It's just what I have been looking at for myself, and I don't need to be, you know, threatened with next council meeting, we're gonna do this, next study session, be ready. We're gonna do this, and every question's gonna be asked and answered. I'm sorry, it doesn't work that way for me. I'm a work in progress, and I'm looking at the charter, and I'm looking at what we're doing, and I'll bring it up as many times as I see fit. And like I said, I'm not saying anybody did anything wrong. I didn't say anybody did anything wrong. We've been operating under some policies. I don't understand some of them. We have some good experience up here. We've got, in this council, there's a lot of years here. The clerk's been here, the mayor, we've been here a long time, and there's some fresh eyes, too. So I am going to look at this some more, and we all are, and we have been. And so that's the part I've seen is real, is that if it's, I think it's an issue as well. So that I am looking into.
You're welcome to kind of...
And I will point out that the last night, the issue wasn't brought up, where we had a closed door sound. That was more like less... I had asked Mr. Plato what was the status. He was not, prepared to or had all the information. I think we have been very clear now, is more be prepared than Plato to talk with the council on this issue. Is there any councilman geographic, if I may?
Yes. This is Ms. Carroll. I want to make sure I know what is it that's your concern? As I understand it, what's your concern is that anything over $2,000 should have sealed bids, is that what your question is?
Well, I believe that's what the charter says, because when it doesn't talk about, it talks about contracts. And I believe a quote is a contract, I believe a perfect, they end up being contracts. If you're going to go put a quote in, you contract with the city to do the job, whether it's just on one piece of paper or whatever. Those are still contracts. I mean, I've been doing the business for years. I mean, proposal kind of contracts, they all are. You're doing work for the city.
Just so through the chair, just so I'm sure,
Mr. Plato,
your question is whether or not the charter requires that any purchase over $2,000 have a sealed bid.
Any contract that the city, goes into, I mean, that's what it says. It just says contract.
I'm trying to differentiate between a sealed bid and competitive bidding, because they're two different things.
Right.
What is your concern?
My concern, well, competitive bidding can be, electronically done and that type of thing, but sealed bids are different to me. And I think when you have a small purchase threshold of $100,000, I mean, it doesn't represent a small purchase to me. I mean, it just doesn't. Those are, my idea of, doing construction was that these prices are set at pretty low to keep things competitive. But keep things competitive, so you're just not passing out work to favorite vendors or anybody who's been doing work for it. And I found a lot of that, and you're going to see it, okay? But when I came here the last time, I wasn't asking about what I'm giving you. That was just something to give to you, a further thing that I'm interested in. I'm only talking about what the charter says and what the change in the purchasing policy was. That's it. I was only comparing in. When you ask me further information, that's totally separate. And it's probably going to show you how our bidding process is currently being done. And just, I'm sorry, to the chair, to the council, do you only review formal bids?
I'm not sure I understand your question.
Well, in the purchasing policy, it says that all formal bids are to be reviewed by the city attorney. And so I'm asking you, do you just review formal bids, or do you ever review bids according to the policy? That's what it says in there.
I don't necessarily agree with that, but all bids,
well, that's what the policy
all bids
says.
Are reviewed by appropriate individuals within the city.
Well, I think they should go beyond that.
Mr. Plato, you understand the questions, and I want to be certain
that's what for the rest of the
ma'am,
not part of the charter, it's part of the purchasing policy.
I haven't seen that in purchasing policy.
Well, it's in the information I'm going to be giving you.
Okay.
And so, okay, we'll close attention to that because.
Let's not try to engineer the solution here, do that, that's, you know, question that's brought up, Madam. Mr. Carroll, please. Understanding is the difference between when is a sealed bid necessary, when is, you know, competitive bid. We know that, you know, going out and purchasing a laptop for $2,001, right? Sending out a bid to Dell to, you know, they're not going to submit a sealed bid for two, you know. We could spend $5,000 to buy a $2,001 laptop. But if you could give a formal reply in your review, if there is anything wrong or not in concert with.